Question is in the state Senate is fueling controversy tonight surrounding drug use. Today, the Senate passed a Baltimore City-sponsored bill to expand its needle exchange program. 11 News reporter David Collins joins us live from Annapolis with the details on that. David.
Well, that bill now goes to the House, where it faces an uncertain future. A high-profile heroin overdose and the carnage from a deadly heroin cocktail has a lot of people questioning the wisdom of giving drug addicts an unlimited supply of clean needles.
The Oscar goes to Philip Seymour Hoffman in Capote.
The February 2nd fatal heroin overdose of Philip Seymour Hoffman.
That story that spoke to me about where I am now in my life.
One of the most admired and versatile actors of his generation. Coupled with the heroin fentanyl drug cocktail that has killed 10 people in Baltimore, stirs concern about expanding the city's needle exchange program. Since 1994, drug users have been getting a clean needle in exchange for their used one. The Senate moved a measure that allows drug users to get more than one clean needle. The bill doesn't set a limit on how many.
To me, it just is a little bit backwards. We need to get people help. Not enable them.
They said that exact same thing when we first passed the bill, when it was we're going to give people needles, or wouldn't that increase drug? Well, it hasn't really increased drug usage, but it has decreased some of the health problems regarding that.
The program serves an estimated 2,500 people each year. It educates users about the dangers of contracting HIV infections through needle sharing. And it refers participants to substance abuse treatment facilities.
By allowing individuals to use a clean syringe every time, we're looking to reduce the risk of reducing hepatitis C, HIV.
The House hasn't moved its version of the bill.
I would much rather see our money, our time, and our energy go into building treatment centers.
If the General Assembly passes the bill, the City Health Department estimates that they will give participants about 60 additional needles each year. Reporting live from Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.